I am going to attempt to make an historic lathe. It looks sort of like a blend of this one and this other one that I saw up here near the top. That's a Roman era style lathe, like that, or like this. It's called a bow lathe, and apparently it's the type of lathe they used in ancient Rome. So that's what I'm going to be making. And we're going to be doing that over here in Milkshape. So I'm just going to make it from concept out of my head into Milkshape and take it all the way to big world format when by the time we're done. So I'm going to start with box. I'm just gonna take a small box like this, and then we're gonna select the verts here. I'm gonna bring it down below just a tad because I was reading that they're mounted in the ground, and then I'm going to make it angled. My box might be too big. So I'm not going to edit anything out. You'll watch me make mistakes and you'll watch me fix them, and hopefully that will help make you a better artist. So you'll see how I do these things. I'm going to put that about halfway in between these boxes here. And move these out here. That's about 3/4 the way across. Okay, and then we're gonna select this group and duplicate selection, and then so that it's equal distance, we will mirror left to right, and there it is. Now we can make another box that had two boards on it going approximately like this, and we definitely don't need it like that, so we need to select those verts. You'll notice I just use these buttons here to choose what I'm selecting. So I click the select button and then I choose if I want to select verts, faces, groups, or joints. Right now I'm selecting verts. So now I want to move it, so I click this button and then I just click and drag with the mouse and move it up like this. And those boards were a little bit longer than they were wide, so I'm going to do it like that. Now I can select this group and first duplicate, and then I'm going to mirror it front to back like so, and now I have that part done. I think, if I recall, there was sort of an upper part, so now I'm going to select these faces. Not by vertex, but by here. Shift, so I shift click to select multiple, shift right click to unselect. Then I'm going to extrude this part here and make it go up. And this is going to be where our little I'm gonna put like a, yeah, it's already starting to look like a lathe. Look at that, isn't that interesting? So here we're gonna put a cylinder through it. And there are too many stacks on that. Well, maybe not actually. Maybe not. I think I know what I need to do here. So what I'm gonna do first, I'm gonna make it bent. And so I don't want it too big. Okay, now I need to select verts. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna shift, well first control and click to move that, and then shift and mouse wheel to zoom in. And I'm gonna select these, so I make this part taller. Yeah. I think that's right. And then that's what I need to do. I just need to select this whole group. And I need to rotate it the way it's gonna be. So it's gonna be like this. It's gonna be here like this. Now I can see what I'm doing. And in the middle here, I'm gonna duplicate this. I might change my mind later. But it's easier to do this now so that it's all the same size. And I'm gonna mirror left to right. There we go. And then I'm gonna select here. And now I'm gonna rotate, and you'll see how. Wait, first, actually, undo rotate. I want to move these in closer so I can make a sharper curve. So I'm just moving these on a line. And I'm going to control click to move those center, shift mouse wheel to zoom in. And then select these, move that in. Think that's the way I want that. I might not have actually saved enough verts, but we'll find out. Undo move. Select verts. Okay, now rotate. So, and then I have to move. Rotate a bit more. Yes, that looks okay. And then I'm going to shift right click to unselect those and then rotate again. And rotate and move. Rotate and move. I see how I want it to look, just like that. Okay. Now click, control, click, and move. And I think I'm just gonna select and rotate. And rotate. Move. Yes, I did need one more row just like that. So what I will do then, so we'll rotate it back. I will end up extruding that. What I'm gonna do. I'm gonna select these and move them down and rotate them and move them out where I want them to be. just like this. And now I'm going to select these faces, and this time I am going to select by vertex, then shift and right click and unselect those. Theoretically, I have the end selected. Yes. And now I can extrude the handle like so and make it as long as I need it to be. Yes, like that. I see it's way off in space over there, but that will be okay. We'll fix that. So now I can move it here. Wherever they are. Where are they? Yeah, they're going. Oh, I'm still selecting. Move. Alright. There, that's in the center. And that is where the little piece of wood that we're going to be lathing will be stuck onto. We'll just like screw it in the middle there, and it will be stuck like that. Some of those, they showed blocks of wood and some don't. They kind of all look, see that one doesn't have, it just has a screw into the end of it. Some do and some don't. So I guess it's all, this is how ours is going to look. Ours is going to look like this. So we want to rename these here. So that's going to be rod, and this will be handle, to name the groups, and this will be B, A, and B. And A. None of them have a material yet. That's okay. I think we about got it though. That went pretty fast. And so then when it works, it will rotate around. And then we'll put a chisel onto the wood. What I'm not sure of is if I need to actually make an imitation piece of wood on the lathe, or if I just need it like this. Maybe just like this is fine. I think something else might be fastened onto here, but that'll work for now. So we want to unselect frame B, our handles, so now we want a new texture. Just gonna have a metal texture, here's my logos, textures, metal. Use that one, I think. So put that here. Go material assign. There we go. Yeah, doesn't like it because of that. So cubic, see if that worked. doesn't like it when I extrude things. So try smooth all. Sometimes it helps. It's not helping this time. It just isn't like it. I'm going to do the texture coordinate editor. I think it's on the handle. I'm going to remap it. And now I'm going to try that again. Tile texture mapper, cubic. Okay. It still kind of looks like that. Alright, that's good enough, I guess. So now select. And now I want these. These will all be wood colors. So I choose the kind of wood I want. I like this one. Let's see if that works. Might have to do... I think I'm probably going to be doing it two different ways. I need one that's already facing both ways. So I didn't have to do this twice. Up and down, up and down. There we go. Cypress. Horizontal. That's going to be on the frame. So I'm going to unselect that. And make a new. And assign. And tile texture mapper cubic. Did that work? Wow, that's really ugly. Why does it look like that? Something is really, really wrong with that. Okay, I think... what's the matter with it? I'll find a different wood. It shouldn't look like that. Oh, I see why. Just a Photoshop instead of PNG. It doesn't like Photoshop textures. I'm surprised it worked at all. There we go. That's a lot prettier. Okay. And now we can make another one. We'll call it wood vertical. And I will be careful not to do that again. There's a wood vertical, and I accidentally clicked it twice, and now I need to unselect those, and select those, and apply texture. And assign the texture. Wait, no, that can't be right. I just made double sure. Why wasn't that? It says PNG. I'll try this one. It doesn't like me today. Okay, copy. Paste. Open. There. Okay. And that one needs to also be tile texture mapper cubic. And fixed. Excellent. Okay, now it looks good. Now we have a nice wooden lathe. And save. And I'm not going to shave it in my tree pack. I have a equipment folder somewhere. There it is. Equipment. And we will call it a lathe. Oh, I forgot the bow. Yes. Alright, let's see. I have to remember stuff. It's really kind of calls into question the handle, doesn't it? Why didn't they think of a handle? The handle can't be right because that's where the bow would attach. That's not what they used, was it? They didn't have a handle like that. Why don't they have a handle? Alright. Oh, look at that. I didn't see that one before. That's got a little bench attached to it. For itty bitty handwork. They do have screw pins, though. And screw pins there. Okay, so we'll change that up a bit. Alright, here's what we do. The screw pins were on both sides, weren't they? So I think I'm going to delete this group here. And then I'm going to select that one and duplicate it. And mirror it left to right. Undo, because it duplicated everything and not just that. Now then, there we go. Yeah, it duplicated the end pieces too. I didn't want that. So now, these, move them in and select and move and select and move. I'll select and move. Some of those are crooked, so I have to fix that. They're quite that crooked. Okay, so now it's still crooked. Stop being crooked. Okay, now I'm gonna push that in more too. And then going to make the middle section fat, so it looks like a turnkey. Or a handle, something you can twist it by. Wait a minute. I want to select all of that in the middle. There we go. Move. And then select. I'm just clicking select and then clicking move and clicking select and clicking move. So now you can kind of see Yeah, that's kind of what I'm going for there. So I have kind of a handle like shape. How you grip it and turn it. And I think this row here needs to be a little closer to this. And then this row here. I'm not selecting very well. Needs to be closer to this. And that looks a little more rounder. More rounder. That's a great word, isn't it? Yes, I'm a homeschool mom. My grammar is terrible when I'm making videos. So shift and scroll first. I'm going to hide that and select and move, because I think it's just a little too... No, wait a minute, I'm squishing the whole thing, aren't I? Yep, edit, undo, and select. Now I can move it. There we go. And select, and shift, unselect, and move. Unselecting with the right click, of course. Select. Shift right click to unselect, move there. That makes it a little flatter. And now I'm just gonna select these and yes, I'm gonna do it this. Should I? No, okay. So shift, unselect, shift, unselect, and I'm going to move it, undo, move, I'm going to unselect the center too, shift, unselect, and I'm going to move that one in, shift, unselect, and then I'm going to move this one back, there, see, that looks like a better twisty handle thing. I think anyway that it does. It's a weird little shape there. I'm not sure what that shape is, but all my other shapes look okay. Let's all look right. All right, I'm not going to worry about it. I think it's okay. If it isn't, well. And it isn't. I think it's near enough. So really, what I'm going to end up doing then is making two of these. So we have our twisty thing here. And now, unhide all. Yeah. So I've got that one. Delete that one, and I'm going to rename this one, Rod A, and then select it and duplicate it, mirror left right, okay, now we've got the handles on both ends just like that one showed, so that's how it would probably screw in. And there's probably a smaller screw thing on there. Maybe I should just do that. The smaller cylinder. Undo. This one really doesn't need that many specs. Maybe three at most. Okay, select parts. Move. Select. Now we're going to make it pointy. I snap together, weld together. Actually, those were pretty good where they were, weren't they? I'm back. Now it's a pointy. And select. And edit. And rotate over here. I didn't need to push that other menu. What I needed was this. And move to here. Center it here, and that looks good. And assign it the metal texture, and duplicate, and mirror left, right. Now there's one on each side, and now that looks like that could hold a piece of wood. And now we need the bow, because that is apparently how they turn this thing, is with a bow. So we need, let's go ahead and save our work here, and so we need another cylinder. And this time I think we need a lot of stacks. So I have to make a bow. My dog is barking again. I wish she would be quiet. Okay, Alright, we're gonna rotate it this way. And move it up here, hopefully in the center, resting on these boards. And then I can select the verts here and start bending it. And rotate. Move up. Zoom that in a little more. And select these and rotate up here. Other way. There we go. Okay. Mouse did not want to go the way I wanted it to go. Okay. Clearly you can see it's a little more bent on one side than the other. I'm trying to fix that. Okay. Now select again. One click, not two clicks. And rotate. And move. And select and rotate and move. Try to match up where these lines are on the grid. And then select and rotate and move. And this might be the last one, because that looks like a pretty good bow. I can at least compare it to the other bows that were in those pictures. Select, rotate, and move. Okay, I think we're gonna go ahead and rotate this. Maybe I move it up. Select, rotate, and move. Maybe rotate a little more. There. Okay, now we have our bow. I think now we need one more cylinder to be the string across the top of the bow. We want it to be from here to here. That is not what I was trying to make. Undo create cylinder. Okay. How far is that? 1, 2, 3, just a little less than 4, so we'll do it like this. Rotate. Move. I think it's still too thick, actually. Yeah, it is. I don't like it. It's too big. Try it again. My mouse slipped. I almost just need a flat plane instead of a cylinder. My actually work better with a flat plane, I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna attach it there. I'm just gonna select those verts there and move them where I need them to be. Right in there. Okay. Oh, and in the wrong place. Alright, there we go. Now we have our bow lathe. And there's the bow. What is that? Oh, that's a nail. Shouldn't be named number. I need to name that a letter. So that's nail B. And that is rod B. Not rid, rod. Or OD, rename, okay. Everything's named properly now. Okay. The bow and the string do not have textures. So I need to select the bow. And I think horizontal will be okay for that. It needs cubic. Wait, what? What happened? I lost all of my textures. I think I know what happened. Not that one. Try again. Tools, texture mapper. Okay. There. Milkshape likes to have its textures all in the same folder with the model. So. And. So we need to select all of these things. Nails and the rods, and retexture them. And they were silver, so I can't really tell very good. I did select them. Select, sign, texture mapper, cubic, okay. Say what it is. It says it's metal. Okay, fine, good enough. And now that I need the string. And I'm going to have to make a new texture for that one.
Because you're chaos.
And I'm going to use a rope texture, but I'm going to call it the string material. Because the material is for the string. The rope, I think, is in cloth. I don't remember where it is. There? Not there. These are not by. There we go. Rope, straight JPEG. Properties, copy, okay, actually, copy to there, okay, and assign window, texture coordinate editor, string, left view, remap. Okay. And now it looks like a string, and we can save the model, because it looks like the lathe. And open it in Ultimate Unwrap. I'm not going to animate it right now. I might change my mind later. I might animate it, but I'm not going to right now. I just want to finish it. Equipment. And there's my lathe. And of course it's huge because Milkshape makes everything huge. I don't need that. Modifiers, scene, scale, at origin, try 0.1, apply, close. That's probably fine. I don't know if it's milkshake makes everything huge or big world requires everything to be tiny, but one way or the other, that is the end result. So now we have our lathe. And can save it as U3D and save as DAE. And export, make sure group saved as message, mesh is. Then we open over here. There's the tree we were working on earlier. And, oh, I'm not ready for this yet. I still have to export it with the exporter. So there's the lathe. And I have to come back up here, put it in the characters folder, because that's what my script is written to recognize, not because it's a character. And now, just call it L-A-T-H-E. I may find later that I need a hard point on it or something like that, but I don't know right now, so we're just going to leave it like this until I know for sure what it needs. And then I kind of think I'll end up needing a hard point so that we can mount a piece of wood to it, but for now we're just going to leave it like this. So we have our lathe model. It doesn't actually have an animation, so I'm not going to copy the animation file. Then come here. It is not an NPC. It is an object. I think that's where it needed to be. Really an object either, but I think that's where we put it. Okay, so I'm gonna just make a new folder. And we're going to call it lathe. And we're gonna put that in there. I'm going to put these in the materials folder. Okay, those were both there already. Yay. I'm just gonna make a new folder. I'm gonna call it cloth because that's where I got it out of, and that's probably what I'll look for again. And I don't need a whole folder just for rope. So now we're ready to open that thing.
I actually like the whole ceiling.
Let's see, objects, lathe model, open. Yes. There we go. It's mostly wood. And what something is happening there. That was weird. This is the vertical. Oh, which one was it? I think it was Cypress. Vert. Good. And oh, why is it doing that? And then materials, wood, cypress, horizontal. And I think I can import metal. Go. Yep. And string materials, cloth, string. Okay, now it is ready and saved, and now it can be scripted to be used as a tool in the game. All done.